The Hack of Shame. Where's the Hack of Shame? Which one's that? Because I know there's plenty of... I mean, there's obviously plenty of bad ones out of the set. You know, it's like, this character in Sonic the Hedgehog. Like, I kind of want to play Silver the Hedgehog just because... Silver the Hedgehog is, like, the worst character ever. You know, he's just like... he's just like, I have to do this to save the future! It's no use! Or whatever, you know. I do apologize for that voice. I'm not sure which one of these is the Hack of Shame. I would play Crazy Sonic if I could, but, again, because I can't find the folder, I can't really do that. The Emperor's New Hedgehog. Yo, let's just pick one at random. Let's go for Sonic 1... Oh, wait, Sonic Green Snake. Where is that? Sonic Green Snake. Oh, here we go. Let's see what this is about. Cause I don't think I've ever seen this one, actually. Like, I've seen a lot of the, you know, 2015 contest submissions. You know, whether it be on stream or on YouTube, you know, I've seen a lot of them. And, yeah, I've seen a whole bunch of other hacks being played on YouTube as well. And I've even played a few myself. Ooh. Classic. Oh, nice, we got the Silver Surf music. Why is the stream so loud? I can barely hear myself talk. Okay, let me fix the sound right here. Okay, that should be fine, I think. But I should hope they've made better hacks. Options, what's... Let's have a look. This doesn't look too bad, actually, so far. oh, I have the good version? What's the bad version, then? Okay, let's see what this does. Yo, I'll play this for a few minutes. I'll play, like, the first level, at least. Where is this music from? Is this from the film? I think this is from Batman Return the Joker on the Game Boy. Because I definitely recall this from before. Okay, actually, I'm not so sure now. Dark Forest. Oh yeah, we've got the Mega Man X music up in this bitch. Yep, that is certainly one Dark Forest. Wait, I want to go to Act 1, but... Okay, well, let's just go to... I want to go to Act 1, because I'm presuming... I probably shouldn't go to the other ones first, because that might be dumb. Yeah, here we go. Oh, yeah. And instantly, if you're wondering why I've put in my description, like, you know, I'm streaming Sonic hacks and bootlegs, it's because, you know what, I feel like my streams need to have some kind of, like, focus to them. And I figured the best thing to do would just be to stick what I know, which is the Sonic games and bootleg games. In fact, I actually go into bootleg games through Sonic games, because, you know, games like Samari and Sonic 3D Blast 5 and whatever. Yeah, those were, like, the first bootlegs that I'd, like, heard of, basically. But yeah, I'll just play the first level of this, and then I'll supposedly move on to some bad ones. Like, ones that... Oh, oh god, well, I died. Okay, well, I think that'll be my cue to move on to something else. What's the bad version like? Like, how does it differ from the good one? Because I'm kind of curious now. Unfortunately, I can't play it, but... Let's play... Hey, I remember... I Hog That Hate Hedge, which I seem to remember is, like, the same game, but in, like, mirrored, I think. Somewhat like that. Let's see. Panada Hedgehog, or Panada Hayhog, possibly? I don't know, but... Let's play Nike. Nike, or whatever. Actually, one thing I was thinking of doing, I was thinking of, like, getting in my iToy and, like, just doing face cam on these streams in, like, the corner or something like that. Because it just says, you know, no playing Sonic hacks or whatever. Okay, and why is... Okay, I've just noticed, like, the JP Ronnie thing on the top of the screen is kind of messed up a little bit. And I do apologize in advance, by the way, that for some reason, Sonic 1, because it wasn't optimized very well in PAL territories, runs kind of slow on the Mega Drive. And, which is kind of annoying. What is the difference between this and the actual game? Like, the font looks a bit different, and that's about it. That's, like, the only difference I notice.
Maybe they changed one of the later levels or something, but I kind of doubt it. It's like they changed like one graphic and that was it, I think. That one graphic just being, you know, not even being really all that noticeable. And if you, like, unless you've played this game a million times, you probably won't even tell. You know. Might as well. I'll give the benefit of the doubt and go to the special stage, but this is pretty lame, should we say. Yeah, this is bad. Just, you know, might as well beat the special stage, even though it's exactly the same as the original, because they were too lazy to change it. I mean, like, what even is Sonic the Hedgehog, or whatever it's called? Hey, Hedgehog, leave those kids alone. Okay. Yeah, I got the Chaos Emerald, who really cares? It's kind of funny that they called the Chaos Emerald, but it's blue. I mean, I know there is a green one, but still. So let's go to Sonic, and let's play... What should we play? Actually, yeah, I just remembered. Silver the Hedgehog. Why is this a thing? Like, why does someone, like, sit down and think, you know what, we need to put Silver the Hedgehog in a good Sonic game. Just Silver the Hedgehog. Just why? Ooh. Okay, let's see what this is about. You know what I kind of want to do, actually? I kind of want to do streams where I just play through a hack. Like, just in its entirety. But I'm not really going to do that today. Well, I don't see Silver yet. Oh, here we go. Messed up colours and everything. Yeah, let's get that sprite. Yeah, his quills don't really look gandry enough, you know, to be Silver, I don't think. And he doesn't have any telekinetic powers, but whatever. You know. It's like, if that means they won't be able to say, it's no use, then, you know, I'll live with it. Oh, actually, I do remember there was a hack where they actually used the Robotnik Get a Load of This voice clip from Sonic Adventure. Which is pretty funny. That was like... Like, I remember, like, hearing that and just bursting out laughing. Because, you know... Sonic Adventure's voice acting is, like, at least for Robotnik, it's amazing. Everyone else was pretty bad from what I remember, but, you know. Except maybe Sonic, really. Yeah. Oh, I probably should have paused right here. Yeah, there's Sonic. Panda... Didn't I play Panda the Hedgehog? Let's try that. Because I thought that was the one I played, unless it was like Sonic the Hedgehog or something like that. Is it Panda the Hedgehog? Let's try that. Let's see what that's about. I don't know why I'm saying Hedgehog. I just figured, like, judging by the title, this would have been developed in, like, you know, somewhere that doesn't speak English. So, yeah. Ooh. Oh, shit. I thought it was Amy Rose for a second. What the hell? Oh, okay, well, this is most likely going to be good then. So I do recognize that name. Yeah, here we go. It's kind of funny that this works on a real mode drive, actually. Because I was kind of hoping to actually play... What's it called? Sonic the Next Level, I believe. Which was developed by the same guy. But I guess I'm going to have to just wait until the next time I do a stream like this. And get all my folders sorted out. Because I know I did a folder and it's not like I deleted it by accident or anything. Yeah. And these graphics. Okay, well, you can't spin dash in this, but I don't think that's really a big deal. Because seeing as it's based on the first game... I do remember the music in the next level being really awesome, actually. Oh. Okay, the platforms don't fall in this one. Oh no! Oh, okay. Where's this music from, by the way? I mean, I don't know where this is from, but you know. Also, like, what does Panda to Hedgehog mean, anyway? I have no idea. I mean, I know Hedgehog is obviously, you know. I'm pretty sure I know what that means. Ooh. Those snares. Ooh. Well, I guess he messed up. Oh, this sounds familiar. I know I've heard this one somewhere, but, okay, that was me being an idiot. Seriously, where's the song from? So I know I've heard this one somewhere else. Oh, no, you don't. So, apparently the place just suddenly turned to winter, just out of nowhere. It's like, you know what? Winter out of nowhere. Oh, well, time to get another extra life. Come on, I need, like, one more ring. Oh, God. Well, I guess I'm not going to get the extra life now. Yeah, well, just barely. I hope the spike bug isn't in this, but, why even hit me there? I guess being in the water hurts you, I guess. Yeah, okay. Because I messed up. Oh, no, you don't. Is this ice physics? Oh, no. It's gonna go well. Yo, I might play this. I was gonna say, like, I might play this more in depth on a stream one day, but we'll have to wait and see, I suppose. Yeah, I was gonna say I might die here, but, oh, no, no. Oh, God. Okay, so it's back to normal. Yeah, I might have to play this more in depth one day. I mean, assuming there's more stages at least. Oh, God, boss time. I mean, if it's... Like, surely they gotta do a boss here, because otherwise... Oh, God. Okay, I have an idea. I know this works, I think. Oh, God. Okay, I didn't realize the ball wouldn't fall me. No, how do I do this? I'm terrible at this. Okay, I think I've got the bead on this now. I hope. Come on, drop that spike from me. Okay. It's kind of amazing that, you know, there are people out there that can do this. Kind of makes me wonder, like, if those people ever really get into, like, the gaming business proper, I suppose. I mean, I probably won't, because, you know, I've never, like, made a video game myself. Like, I've made, like, the closest I've ever come to, like, making a game at all is, like, Doom mod, where I, like, you know, make my own levels and stuff. Like, that's it. And even then, there's only, like, two that I actually took seriously, which was like, one was like a single player game, which was like ridiculously hard from what I remember, because I just didn't bother to like properly balance it out. So yeah, I kind of want to like make one that's like, you know, reasonable difficulty, but you know, like I made that, and then there was like a, oh God, okay, I messed up. How many hits has he taken this? Like, because he takes 8 in the original. What's the point? There's going to be like a second phase of this where I'm just going to like die immediately. In fact, yo, I've just remembered Moonwalk. Michael Jackson's is my favorite game. Also, yeah, terrible stage in Sonic 4. What you mean, all of them? I jest, of course, but like I remember when I played Sonic 4 and just went, you know, this game isn't that bad, and then I just went, you know what, no, this game sucks. That's all I remember, like, from when I played Sonic 4. You know, I might play it again someday, just to see if I can actually beat it, but, I can kind of see why they never made an episode 3 of that, let's just say that much. Okay, well, I'm not gonna risk dying right here. Yeah. There's one thing I've learned over the years is that I tend to be pretty rubbish when it comes to video game bosses. I felt like Sonic is like the one game series where I can actually beat most of the bosses pretty easily. Oh, okay, I seem to have won. Maybe. Let's see. Yeah, I did it. Oh, is that it? I guess I've won. Because that seemed to be about it. Let's see if there's a level select in this, actually. Like, if that actually works. Yeah. To be honest, I kind of want to get into, like, hacking Sonic games. Like, do my own stuff with them. But, yeah. Wait, did they really end episode 2 on a cliffhanger? Okay, good job on that one, Sega. See. I want to see if level select is in this. Let's have a look. It doesn't seem to be as well as I can tell. I mean, I pressed up, down, left, right, and it doesn't do anything. But yeah, that was Panda the Hedgehog. That was pretty cool. Let's see. Yeah. For some reason, like, game companies seem to be allergic to the number 3 nowadays. Like, it doesn't matter if it's, like, Valve or Sega or, you know, anyone. You know, it's just like, I'm not going to make a third game. What is Jukebox Hill Zone, by the way? Is that just music, I guess? I mean, it's not going to be, like, digital, like... Oh, yeah, digital. It's not going to be, like, you know, PCM music or anything, because it's only, like, 512 kilobytes. If they could fit that into that, then I would be amazed. But, of course, if they did, it would probably sound terrible. Oh. Okay. So let me guess. Oh, is this just the same? I don't understand why there are so many hacks, by the way, that are based on the original version of Sonic and not the revised version. Seems kind of weird. So, what is... Okay, what is the difference between this and, like, the regular game? Yeah, so let's just see if there's any difference in the gameplay. In fact, you know what? Oh, okay, so they changed the level design. But I think after this hack, I'm actually gonna... Help? Oh, I see. So it's just, like, every time you hit a box, it plays different music. And they changed the level design a little bit. But yeah, I think once I'm done playing this, I'm going to briefly test my actual Sonic 1 cartridge. Just to see what version it is. Because I don't think I even bothered to check when I did that before. Come on, where the box is at? Oh, yes. I know there's more boxes around here, but I just can't find them right now. It's kind of funny, it's like, especially considering Sonic 1 is like one of the few games that I can actually play to an extent. It's especially funny because, like, I'm good enough at Sonic 1 to the extent that I've actually beaten Samari. So, yeah. And believe me, beating Samari is no easy task, especially considering how much I suck at games, usually. Yeah, did it. Okay, here's my copy of Sonic 1. I mean, the game runs slow regardless of what version you have, but still. So, let me just... don't worry, I will get back to the hacks in about a minute. I just want to shed some right here. Sonic the Hedgehog. Blue Streak Speeds, boy. no one remembers Sonic Saturday AM. In fact, I remember one night I actually decided to, like, watch a bunch of episodes at, like, 1:30 a.m. or something like that. So let's see. Oh, no, this is the original one. This is not the revised version. That kind of sucks. Because I'm pretty sure they fixed a bunch of bugs in the later version. Oh, well. That's like the Hedgehog. The original. I think I might do, yeah. Like I said, I'm pretty certain I will do a stream on that at some point and just play the actual game. And I will do streams where I'll play the hacks more in depth. Because, you know, there's only so many streams that you can do just, like, flicking through them, I suppose. So, yeah. What else can I play? Cause I actually kind of wanted to play Crazy Sonic, even though it's completely terrible. So, yeah, I played Nike, which is apparently exactly the same as the regular game. Oh, yeah. Sonic the Hedgehog. I'm actually going to play this, because I remember, like, playing this, and I remember being completely terrible. I think I might have actually kind of beaten this hack. I'm not sure. Did someone actually made a faster version of Sonic 1? Because I would totally play that. Like, if I wanted to stream Sonic 1, I would play that instead of just the regular thing. Because, honestly, like, my big concern of playing Sonic 1 on the Mega Drive was just simply the fact that the Windstone... I mean, look at these graphics. In fact, I'm actually going to do some right here. Assuming this works in the hack. So, 1992... November 24th... Oh, that not work. Oh, solid, it's just the start. The... was it? The Lucky Rock Zone, I think it said. Yeah. This, by the way... this is the worst hack I've ever played. And it's kind of funny, this is the first one I streamed, and nothing is even come close to being this bad. I just kind of want to play it again. Like, I'm probably just going to keep coming back to this hack just because of how bad it is. I mean, first off, the graphics is just like... well, I can't even speak today. I cannot grammar for the life of me. But, yeah, like, I just remember this being... I mean, they obviously took the graphics from, like, Hidden Palace Zone and just, you know, made the graphics, like, this horrible-looking neon nightmare that I'm in right now. Oh, no, you don't. And I remember you can, like, fall through the ground at points because they didn't bother programming the collision detection properly. Why was Sonic's face when I get hit? But, you know, after I'm done with this, I'm actually going to look and see if I got the, that Sonic 150Hz thing. If it's a really recent hack, then chances are I won't have it. Okay, let's go up here. So I'm assuming I got it. There better be checkpoints right here. Oh god. That doesn't seem good. Let's go up here. Actually, I have a little question to everyone watching right now. Is there anything in particular you'd like to see me stream? Like, not necessarily, like, particular games, although you can, you know, kind of request that as well, but is there any kind of particular kinds of games, or topics, or whatever that you would like to see me do on these streams? Yeah, got to a chip one at least. Isn't the two packs of this garbage? Yep, I think I just lost, because I can't actually do anything right here. Yep, good job whoever made this. So, I might have to come back to that one day and just play through it again. Hopefully figure out a level select cheat or debug mode or something. But, yeah. Hex. Let's see. Have I got Sonic 1? Yeah, cut off out of 10 indeed. Yeah, more like I bleed out of 10. I don't think I have that hack. I'm gonna have to look that up after I'm done streaming and add it to this. Oh wait, okay, I do have it, I think, because assuming this is the right ROM, and assuming this works on the Mega Drive, because I know that there are plenty of hacks that don't work on this, and, you know, in that case, I'm just gonna have to emulate them. I kind of don't want to play emulated Mega Drive games, partly because I don't... oh. Okay, that sounded a bit off, but I don't want to play. Oh, I think I think someone messed up. That's a nice Nightcore remix right here. I was kind of hoping, judging from the title, I actually assumed that this would just be Sonic 1 running at 60 frames a second, or, you know, running at the NTSC speed. Okay, let's actually play this. See how far I can get before I die. Okay, so the fade-in effect takes just as long as it does on the real thing. Oh, look at this. I'm speedrunning my way through this. Yeah. I like how the time is still going the same. Yeah. 14 seconds, baby. Talk about pro skills. Look at that, 50,000 points. Okay, and this is also based on the original version of the game, which is kind of annoying, but whatever. Seriously, though, if there is a version of Sonic 1 where they've, like, fixed the PAL version and optimized it to make it as fast as the NTSC one, please tell me, because I would totally stream that instead of just the regular game. If I could do this just in case. Okay, what is up with the fish? Okay, that's strange. Imagine playing Scrap Brain Zone like this. In fact, maybe, like, one day I'm gonna, like, stream Sonic 1 and then stream this and see how far I can get. Okay, I've died. Yep, this is going real well so far. But I'll just be like, hey, I just ace Sonic 1. Let's play this incredibly fast version and die in Act 2 with Green Hill. I'd definitely go faster, like, compared to the original. And I mean, in terms of, like, relative to everything else. Because you'll notice, like, only half the stuff goes faster. Which is kind of weird. Yeah, look at that. See, this shouldn't be called, you know, faster edition. This should be called the Nightcore version. I'm just going to say that right now. In fact, you know what's funny? I think, because, like I said, this weekend I'm going to be streaming bootleg games. I was originally going to make it bootleg Sonic games, but now it's like, you know what, I'm just going to make it just bootleg Game Boy games in general. Okay. Why are the springs so bad in this? Like, they only play like half as high as they normally do. So, yeah, that's good. Oh, okay, that was strange. But can I at least... Oh, give me that extra life. Okay, so apparently... the invincibility's worn off, and... Okay, apparently, if I go down there, I die. So that's... Okay. Can you even get up to the top half of the level? Because given the way these springs work out... Oh, yeah, I guess you can. So I guess I'm going to have to stay on the top half of the level to have any chance of beating it. These controls are so weird compared to the original. It's like, what was I gonna say? I think I got a plan in mind. Basically, on the I think I have an idea here actually. But I was gonna say, on the weekend I'm gonna stream Game Boy bootlegs, focusing on Sonic bootlegs on Game Boy. But I'm just gonna play all the ones that I have that I can actually play on my Super Game Boy. I mean, the thing is, I would play them on my... Oh. Okay, that was weird. I went straight through that. I was gonna play on the Game Boy Player, I think it's called, on GameCube. The problem being that I don't have one, meaning that it's not really feasible, because, you know, if I don't have one, I can't exactly stream off one. And that's a damn shame, because I do want to get a Game Boy Player at some point. Well, that was easy. Yeah. Yo, I probably could, like, if I really wanted to, I probably could beat the game like this. In a few tries, I guess. I don't know. I mean, as you can see, I beat Act 3 in less than a minute, so, yeah. It's kind of funny how, if you beat it in 59 seconds, you only get 5,000 time bonus. I thought it was more than that, but I guess not. That bass drum. Okay. So let's keep going right here. Let's do it. Select game. So if I take a look at the Master System stuff, I do wonder, are there any hacks of Sonic games on the Master System? I don't know. I was gonna say. Actually, I just remembered, yeah, Rainbow Islands. I remember that sucked on the Master System. Because I think they literally just took the NES version, like the worst NES version, and just put that on the Master System. And I seem to remember there's like a game breaking bug where like the game crashes near the end. So yeah, good job whoever programmed that. I'm not even sure we even developed that port. In fact, speaking of bad ports on the Master System, Street Rage 2, I remember it really sucked as well. Because like the enemies just combo you to death and you really can't do anything about it. Like, in fact, Street Rage 1 was a lot better. Funny enough. But as you can see, we've got all these Sonic games. Sonic Chaos, Sonic Spinball, Sonic 1 and 2. Sonic Drift 2, Sonic Blast, Sonic Triple Trouble. Yeah. And Mean Bean Machine, which should be in this bit. Yeah. I also got the classic Dr. Hello. Actually, yeah, let's briefly try out Sonic Triple Trouble and see how well that works. Hopefully, it should work, I think, because they did just port this from the Game Gear and, you know, change the cold palette and stuff to make it work on the math system, so it should work, I would imagine. But let's just have a quick look, just to be sure. And I know the pause button doesn't do anything on this, because, of course, the math system has a pause button on the console itself, inexplicably. And yeah, I did briefly try this out on an emulator just to make sure it worked. So, yeah, I kind of knew that glitch coming, as well as the dark palette in the background for some reason. I don't know what that's about. I always find it weird that when you play math system games on the Mega Drive, you use the B and C buttons and not the A button, which is kind of strange. I'm really going to have to fix the frame for the stream at some point. Like, I'm going to have to change the colour for, like, the text border on the top. So I might as well just have a quick go with Sonic. I've never actually played Triple Trouble that much, to be honest. Because the problem is, as a kid, I didn't really have many Game Gear games. Like, I'm going to say this right now. The Game Gear was actually the first system that I ever played. In fact, Sonic 1, I'm pretty certain, was the first game I ever played on the Game Gear. So, you know, because of that, I have a lot of nostalgia for it, and I really like the game. It's by far my favourite Sonic on the Game Gear. Even if this might be better in a lot of respects, I still prefer the first game. I don't know. It's just got something charmed with that. The other games just don't have as much, I don't think. I felt like the first game had kind of the right balance of difficulty, at least on the Game Gear. Okay, so I know you can go that way, but I'm not going to, because I'm not sure. Can you get a Chaos Emerald on Act 1, or is it just Act 2? Don't remember. But yeah, like, Sonic 1 on the Game Gear, for me, kind of had the right balance of difficulty. Like, it wasn't too difficult, but it wasn't, you know, it wasn't ridiculously easy either. Like, Sonic 2 was too difficult. Sonic Chaos is, like, insanely easy from what I remember. It's like, if you've ever beaten a Sonic game before, you'll get through that, like, no problem at all. It pretty much plays like this game, only 10 times easier. And this game isn't even that hard from what I've played. Oh yeah, I remember this. Yeah, I think you do have to go to Act 2 to get the Chaos Emerald. I don't remember how to get it, but yeah. And the border changes colour. You know, as you can see, they didn't bother to fix the stage design for the math system. But then again, this is a like fan-made port, you know. I will give them major props just for even doing that. So yeah. Anyway, I'm going to be right back. So I'm actually going to put on some music, even though it's going to take a while to, you know, load a game that has music that I can play. I was going to put Truxton on, but then I remembered that doesn't even have a sound test, which is kind of dumb, in my opinion. Let's go with the classic game. I want to go to R for the classic, if I can find it. Revenge of Shinobi, yes. Because I've been playing this game a fair bit recently. I haven't beaten it, but I remember it gets pretty damn tough later on. But I'm just going to play the music for a bit while I go and, you know, do stuff. Does this not work? Why does this not work? This is just a standard Mega Drive game, what the hell? I mean, I don't want to have to just, like, get out the... I don't want to have to get out the friggin', you know, Mega Games 2 cartridge just to play, you know, Revenge Shinobi. It's a good thing I kept that, actually, because, you know. Fine, I'll load something else. So the greatest game of all time. Even though, I mean, this does have a pretty cool soundtrack, actually, I will say. If it loads. I might play it for a bit once I come back, and then, you know, get back to the regularly scheduled program, which is, of course, Sonic Hacks. But let's load this first. Because I kind of want to just play this for the sake of it. Even though, this is going to sound weird, but I actually have a multi-cart that has Action 52 on it. It's like 59 in one. It's like Action 52 and then like 7 other games, which are like way better. Like it has Sonic, it has Streets of Rage. It actually has the Tiny Toon Adventures game, which is a really cool game from what I remember. But I'm just going to play some music right here. And I will be right back. Yeah, I just bit the head off. That's because I just bit the head off the friggin' Milky Bar kid. Weird sensation. But, yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna quickly play the game where I got my namesake from, or at least one of the versions of it. Level 1. The Cheetahman. It's kind of funny how this is actually worse than the NES version. I mean, the NES version was pretty bad, but this is like... I've tried playing this a bunch of times. I don't think I've ever beaten level 1. I can't even remember. But, it sucks. Okay, let's just say that much. Mainly because you have to be like 3/4 of the way across the screen before it actually scrolls. So, good job to program this. It's kind of hilarious how a large chunk of the, you know, Sonic modding community actually have better programming skills than whoever did this hack. Or whoever did this game. I mean, look at this. Oh, welcome to the stream. How are you doing? Oh, and of course, because I pressed the C button at just the perfect time, I got killed without having any chance to get away. Because if you press the C button at a certain time, which is the attack button, you just die. You're basically just a buggered. Okay, so there we go. I managed to kill that time. And guess what? When you die, those cages that you collect, they reappear. So, yeah. You'll stop this game. I'm going to go back to the Sonic hacks, because some of those are actually fun. In fact, most of them are fun on some level. Whether it be, you know, legitimately good, or just so bad it's good. So what should I play? I like how I have, like, I literally have 25 pages of just Sonic hacks. What is S2A Beta? Is that just one of the prototype versions of Sonic 2? Because there's no way in hell I'm ever going to dedicate a stream to just a prototype of Sonic 2. I mean, maybe a stream on, like, every single one, but not just one of them. Yeah. Actually, you know one thing that's really nice about Hitbox? Because I'll be honest, I'm really glad that I'm streaming on Hitbox now, because it's a lot more convenient to see how the stream's going. But, you know, the CU is online and all that. So, go. Oh, okay, this isn't actual prototype. This is the Sonic 3 music. What the hell's going on? So is this just Sonic 2 with Sonic 3 music? Or... Oh, okay, it's got different levels too. This might actually be pretty cool, but we'll see. Bastard. Yeah, so it's part of my fault, but still. Yeah. It's kind of funny how the music sounds exactly the same, like they literally just ported over the sound engine for the third game too. Oh, here we go. Kaboom. So let's see. I can't... To be honest, I really can't wait for it to be the weekend. Because the thing is... For me, for me personally, a weekend is pretty much the same as a weekday. You know, except... Everyone's at work. You know. And the problem with, you know, everyone being at work is in school and whatever is, they're all busy and all that. I don't really get to talk to a lot of people during the weekdays. I mean, you know, obviously there's always a few people that are around. And I thank those people for talking to me and all that sort of thing. So they've basically just taken the original levels and just, like, altered them very slightly. I guess you can see they changed the background right here, but that's really about it. I always find it funny how, like, Hilltop Zone in this is just this level, but with a different background and different colours. I guess they just, you know, ran out of space with graphics at one point and went, you know what, we're just gonna, like, oh wait, yeah, I forgot about that dick move. It's like, why if you put a spring there if it just makes you crash to an enemy? It's like, okay, good job of designing that. But, what was I gonna say? I was about to say, as a kid, the only Sonic game I had on the Mega Drive was actually Sonic 2. I never had the other ones. I mean, I had Sonic 3, but I had that on the PC rather than on console. And, so yeah, as a kid, I played Sonic 3D with MIDIs rather than, you know, the original soundtrack. And I'll be honest, I actually really like the new tracks they put into the MIDIs for Sonic 3. You know, a lot of people say they suck, I don't care. I like those songs. I mean, maybe it's just me, but I've never liked Carnival Night Zone in the Mega Drive Sonic 3. I just always thought it's some kind of... You know, it's just like a remix of Carnival, you know, the generic circus music. never really cared for it much, but yeah. So I'm guessing this is literally just Sonic 2 with Sonic 3 music, and that's basically it. I mean, there's not really a whole lot to say. Yeah. I mean, if the music was, like, original, if they took it from, like, other places and something like that, it might be interesting, but, like, as it is, not so much. But, yeah. Also, it's that they only take the music from, like, one of the acts. Okay, I remember this. Let's go this way. I'm gonna play this one level and then I'm gonna, like, move on. Because I just like Chemical Plant Zone that much to where I kind of, you know, I kind of have to play it. Like, this was, like, as a kid, this level was the jam. Even though I always struggled to get past the, what's that, Mega Pod or whatever it's called? Sonic the Ring Road, too. Is that like the Rainbow Road from Mario 64? Because that would be pretty cool. I mean, I doubt it, but I don't know. Imagine, like, a Sonic act based on that with the music and everything. Hopefully it's like the magic carpet, bro, from Aladdin. But yeah. Well, and I'll be there to warn. What's with the colours, by the way? I mean, obviously it's part of the hack, but still. Anyway, I think I'm kind of done with that. There's not really much more I can really say with the game, really. Actually, you know what? I have an idea. Because there's so much stuff that I want to stream. Like, I want to stream the Master System Sonic games. And I really want to stream the Dreamcast Sonic games. At least the Sonic Adventure games. Oh god, Sonic 1 Omocho Edition. I have seen that. I have seen that on YouTube before. I'm not sure if I have it. But if I do have it, I am definitely playing it. Because it's friggin' Sonic 1 Omocho. I don't think I do. Well, actually, no, let's see. Sonic 1. I'm going to have to look at every single ROM that I have that says Sonic 1 on it. Sonic 1 Random. Sonic 1 255. Sonic 1 and Knuckles. Well, that... Yeah. Stupid dogs. See, I've never liked dogs. It's just... I don't know. It's just the kind of person I am. Do I have Omocho Edition? I don't think I do. Wait, what the hell? Sonic 1 Rape. Okay, I don't know what that's about. I'd rather not. Sonic the Ring Road 2. I mean, I will play that one next, but I really want to see if I got the Omocho Edition. Sonic 2, the Ring Road, the Lost Land. Sonic 2 and Knuckles, which... Isn't that just the regular Sonic 2 and Knuckles? Like, you know, you put Sonic 2 on Sonic and Knuckles. In fact, yo, I just had an idea for a stream that I need to do sometime. I need to take my copy of Sonic & Knuckles and try all of my bootleg carts on it and see what happens. In fact, I even have a couple of multi-carts that have actual Sonic games on them. So, yeah. But yeah, Sonic 2... The Ring Road. Yes. Sonic 2... To be honest, I should probably change this so it says Aluminium Edition, but okay. Where is the Ring Road? Because I don't see it anywhere. Sonic 1 Open Source Project? Ring Road 3 and 4. Okay, I don't see where that is. Maybe I'm just being an idiot. But, yeah, I don't see where it is. Which page is it on? Because I have no idea. Sonic 2 Home and Attack. Well, that might be interesting. Well, vaguely for a few minutes, but, Sonic 2. So, Sonic 1, Hank the Hedgehog. I'm totally going to have to play that sometime. Please tell me it's Hank Hill, because I would love that. Let's see. Sonic 1, Lunacy Metallics. It's like the mechanics, but done by Metallica, I suppose. Which I suppose would just be the Four Horsemen, but still. Sonic CD music. I'm trying to remember what that is. I think that is literally just like the tracks from the game, just ported to the Mega Drive. Sonic, I just had to do it. I remember playing that. Hank. In fact, wasn't there like a hack of Mega Man 6 called like Rockman 6 Hank or something like that? Because I remember seeing that on like a pirate multi-cart. Sonic 1. I really hope I do have the Homer Chow hack on here. Green Road. Sonic Jam 6, oh god. Translated to Russian. Okay, that's gonna be fun. Oh, okay, I do have Sonic Rings 2. So we can go for Sonic Rings 2 and Sonic Rings 2 Pro. I wonder what the difference is. Page 15 or 13. So I have Sonic Rings 1, 2, and 3. Sonic 1, Omocha Edition. I just want to check to see if I actually do have that somewhere. Because I kind of want to play that. If not, I'm just going to have to download it, I suppose. Sonic 1, Gotta Go Fast Edition. Oh, okay, let's check page 13 then. Sonic the Hedgehog 2. Oh wait, Sonic the Hedgehog Bird Edition. Isn't that one of the contest entries? I definitely remember that. Oh god, well, I'm definitely playing that. But first, let's play Sonic Rings 2. See what this is about. This is either going to be really awesome, or it's going to be really horrible. I'm predicting it now. Because there's very rarely an in-between with these hacks. They're either really awesome, really terrible, or just really lazy. That's what it seems to be. I mean, there's very few that are just like, you know, they're okay, but they're not special. So what is this? I wonder what the pro version does to this. Wait, in 2007, this can't be good. Heaven Hill. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to plug that. Okay, so is this just a case of hold right to win? Oh, okay, that's not. Well, maybe so. Let's see. Yeah, I can hold right to win. Because that's totally what Sonic was all about before. It's kind of funny, there are people that, you know, say that about Sonic games, and it's like, you play it and it's like, well, no, because you do have to press right and jump and all that. Well, I got an extra life. Okay, what do I have 5 lives? I shouldn't have, like, 4? Or, oh, I think I collected an extra life, sod it. But, yeah. Yeah, 60,000 points, because I'm awesome. They need like 10,000 points to continue. Because I'm pretty sure I just crushed that. Time to play Act 2. Let's go up here. So it's just a Sonic 2 with like really bad level design, I guess. I mean, the color pattern change isn't that bad, even if it is pretty minimal, but. Okay, I'm not sure if they really changed this one that much. Oh. Well, let's go do that then. Oh, got that minty green background. Because minty green is the best kind of green. Yeah. See what the bot looks like then. Spring over here, isn't it? Yep. Let's go and call that. Bastard. I don't get worried. Why do, like, level designers for this game have a habit of having springs that make you crash into the monkey? The monkey's a git. And, yeah, the boss is the same. Yeah, Mario Maker. To be fair, I have seen good Mario Maker levels. I've never actually played Mario Maker, though. Like, I feel like I probably should at some point, but... You know, it's like... Honestly, there isn't really much I'm excited for on the Wii U. Like, literally, the only game that I actually really want to get is, what's it called? Redeye the Sky Soldier. In fact, once I'm done streaming, I think I'm actually going to look at the website and maybe try to, like, pre-order the Special Edition. Because I believe that version actually comes with the Wii version of the game. Because, Redeye the Sky Soldier, for those who don't know, was actually designed for the Wii. And then the game was cancelled at the last minute. And now NIS America is putting out the game on... they basically decided to publish the game themselves. So yeah. Well, what the hell's going on? I'm just holding down right now. I'm not even pressing right. Oh well. Actually, yeah. Come to think of it, you really aren't kidding when you say this is like Mario Maker. Because I just remembered those levels where you just don't even press anything. It's like... It's like the kind of cool looking a lot of the time, but at the same time, it's like why would you want to play that? It's kind of cool to watch. That's my problem with a lot of games, I feel. Like, maybe it's just me, but I find there's a lot of games over there where I honestly think it's more fun to watch them than to play them. Like, that's why I'm really apprehensive with playing Undertale. It's like, you know, maybe the game is fun, but at the same time, like, honestly, I just feel like I would enjoy it more if I just watched someone else play it. I mean, I haven't watched anyone else play it. Originally because of lack of interest, and later on just because I didn't want to have anything spoiled for me. But yeah. Or, you know, any, you know, plot points or anything like that. I mean, gameplay, not so much. But yeah. People could spoil, you know, gameplay tips or whatever to me all day long, but I don't really care. You know, I kind of need all the gameplay tips I can get for most games. Yeah. But, yeah. Anyway. Done with that, because there's not really much else to say. I really hope the Elmo Chow hack works, because I kind of want to play that just because of how ridiculous it is. So let's play, what's it called? Page 17, I think it was on. Sonic the Hedgehog Elmo Chow Edition. The greatest game of all time, and you know it. Okay, this is 5 people on the stream, but I'm guessing one of those is me. So, yeah. Not that it really matters, of course. Because, you know what, as long as at least one person is watching, it's worth it. Well, you know. I mean, to be honest, like, half the reason I do these streams is to entertain the people that come to them. And, you know, I like uploading these to YouTube later on. But, I don't think this works, unfortunately. To be honest, I'm probably just going to watch it on YouTube later. Because I'm pretty certain this just isn't going to work. It's too weird. In fact, I can't... I don't know. I think one of these days I'm just going to stream it on an emulator. And just try to, like, see if I can get anywhere in it. But, yeah. Unless maybe I have, like, another version that I could try out. But I don't think so. Because otherwise it would have surely been grouped with it. Sonic 2010. Oh god, Sonic 3 and Rainbow Dash, that sounds like a classic. To be honest, I wasn't sure if there would be any, like, My Little Pony hacks on here, but I guess so. I wasn't really paying enough attention to the names when I downloaded these, because I just took all the hacks from, like, non-good gen, and just stuck them all on here. Like, basically anything that looked like it would be, like, Sonic. Honestly, what is Sonic CD21? Is that going to be Sega CD game, or is that actually going to work on a Mega Drive? I don't know. Because, you know what, I really want to get a 32X, partly just to play the 32X games, because apparently the Everdrive can run those if you have a 32X. But I also want to get it because I know there's a few hacks of Doom, including one that I think is based on Sonic Robo Blast 2, which I never really played the actual mod much, but I know, you know, I'm kind of familiar with what it is and all that. In fact, if you look at my 32X folder, I literally just got everything. So, you know, we got the greatest game of all time, you know, 36 great holes starring Fred Couples, because, you know, there's no arguing that that is the greatest game of all time. And then, of course, we also have Calibri, Knuckles Chaotix, which I've never played Knuckles Chaotix, I don't think. Because they never include it on any of the compilations for whatever reason. I mean, I'm sure they could, but they just decided not to because reasons. Virtual Racing Deluxe. What's really funny, I actually have Virtual Fighter on the 32X. Even though I don't have a 32X itself. The reason I have it is because there was like a local market around here that was selling it for like £4. And I was like, you know what, I might as well. Even though I don't have a 32X, I want to get one day, and I figured, you know... Oh yeah, Star Wars Arcade was on the, thing. I forgot about that. Anyway, let's get back to the regularly scheduled stuff, I guess. Is it even worth playing the character hacks? Because I'm pretty sure they're just the original games, but with a different character. You know, different sprites, and that's it. It's like playing those bootleg Mario hacks on the Famicom, where it's like... Oh, it's the Flintstones, except you play as Mario and it's called Granddad for some reason. What is, I want to see if there's, like, a beta or something like that. Sonic 2 new ability. Sonic 2 no time limit. Let's have a look at Sonic 1 Hank of the Hedgehog, because I'm kind of curious to see what that is. It's probably going to suck, but I might as well at least have a look. To be honest, I do wonder if, like, fixing the checksum on some of these ROMs would make it work on the Mega Drive. I don't know. And I'm guessing, like, if it comes up with Soft Mega, that means it doesn't work. I think. I don't know. I mean, I should probably look into this stuff more to, like, know what all this stuff means. In fact, let's see. Options. Hard reset. Region. Well, of course I'm going to have Region 3. But I'm going to have that. Honestly, I'm kind of tempted to try out, like, Puyo Puyo 2 on this thing. Because I kind of want to play that anyway. Not right now, but, where is it? Puyo Puyo 2 or Sue or whatever. Yeah. Because I know Puyo Puyo 1 is just me B Machine. Which I don't actually have. I mean, I have a large chunk of the games. Like, I have that. You know, I have the main three games. And, you know, Knuckles and Spinball. I have all those, but, so what should I play? Sonic 1 Splats the Rabbit. Which I'm pretty sure is just, like, an unused enemy from the first game. I'm arsing around too much on these menus, actually. Let's just pick a random game. Let's go with Sonic 2, but keep Tails or else. This is going to end well. I mean, I think I have a pretty good idea of what this is going to be. It's got that classic Sega. Yeah. So, GT is awesome. One chance multi. Let's go for one chance. Let's see how far I can get on one life. Oh, wait, it says I have three lives. What the hell? Oh, is it the amount of lives that Tails has then? I'm not sure. So, I'm guessing if Tails gets hit, then he dies, and then you, like, die as well. Yeah, like that. Game over. Wait, you could pause on the game over screen. I didn't know that, actually. Then again, I haven't got game over on Sonic 2 in so long. It's like, I think the last time I got game over on Sonic 2 was, well, I mean, it was so long ago, I can't even remember. So, yeah. And even then, I was like, you know, that was like the final boss. Because, like, I could beat Sonic 2. The final boss is a bit of a pain in the arse, though. So let's keep Tails this time. Make sure it doesn't die. Unfortunately, the invincibility doesn't make him invincible. So, come on, Tails. You gotta do it. Yeah. At least he hasn't got himself killed yet. So this is just like Sonic the Escort Mission. Why are escort missions even a thing in video games? It's like, has there ever been, like, a good escort mission in a video game? Because I'm sort of just trying to think right now if there is, but can't think of any. Yes, oh. So, so he just, like, randomly died out of nowhere. That's great. Okay, well, I think I'm done with that. I don't think there's much else to say, but, yeah. I wonder how long I should go for with this. Let's play. There's any Sonic hacks in here. Sonic the Ring Ride 4. Okay. I'm not sure where that is in the menu. I know I have the first three. But let's see. Sonic the Ring Ride. Sonic 2. The Ring Ride. Let's see. I'm keeping an eye out for this. It's like 2 underwater, I remember that. Escort missions just tend to bug me a lot of the time. They just tend to be a pain in the arse, usually, from what I remember. So, let's see. Sonic into the... No, Sonic. Where is it? Sonic Rings 1, 2, and 3. Sonic Sad Hill. Sonic the one ring. Where is the ring ride for? Sonic Reed and Amy. Sonic, the Rise of Chaos. Build a burger. Is that just Burger Time, but with Sonic 2 music? Okay, let's go back. Let's see if I can find this. Sonic 2 Beta 4. I suppose I didn't just download all of them, to be honest. But, yeah. Sonic 2 Secret Rings. Oh, yeah. What's funny? I was actually thinking of getting Alien Syndrome on the Wii, but I didn't know if it was any good. I hadn't actually bothered to read into it. Where is this hack? Is it here, maybe? Sonic 2 Adventure Edition. Sonic 2 with Sonic 4-ish palettes. That sounds like a winner. Sonic 2 Battle Race. Sonic 1... Seriously. Okay, the last thing we need in a Sonic game is friggin' Drake. Yeah. See, the thing about me is, I'm not a fan of RPGs usually, but I do like action RPGs. Pretty much. In fact, I'm actually trying to get a copy of East 2 on the Famicom. Because, page 5. Okay, let's see. Oh, I thought it was Sonic 2, not Sonic 1. Okay. Yeah, I was getting confused because I thought it was Sonic 2 hack. Because the last one was. But okay, let's do it. It's kind of funny, there's a lot more hacks of the first two games than the third one. Then again, honestly, I kind of prefer the first two games over 3 and Knuckles. I mean, I know a lot of people say that one's the best, but personally, I'm not one of those people. Let's see what this is about. So I'm guessing I can hold right to win again. Let's do it. Well, nice background glitch right there. Reminds me of Sonic Genesis on the Game Boy Advance, actually, that does. Oh god, what? What's going on with the colours? No! Is it going to sunset, maybe? Oh, okay, so... Whoa. Oh god, the hell? So is this like Sonic 1 LSD edition, then? Fine, I'm gonna hold the C button and see what that does. Oh god. Oh, do I have to hold all of them, maybe? So I guess if I hold all of them... Yeah, I'm gonna say this right now. The reason the music and everything is slower is because... Okay, if you don't know, basically, the PAL version of Sonic 1 was very poorly optimized. As in, they just didn't bother optimizing it at all. So essentially, the game just runs a lot slower than it does on NTSC. So this time, I'm actually going to hold... Oh. So I guess it doesn't actually work until it comes up with a thing. This hack is weird. Like, it's kind of weird seeing this work on a real Mega Drive, but yeah. If it's a kind of... Oh, God. Sod it. Let's just hold all the buttons down. See how far I can get. Super tells me I can't actually get past this loop. Maybe if I just stand here for a while. No. I was thinking maybe I could jump high enough, but I don't think so. Yeah, I'm going to have to do this. And then I'm going to die on this bit. Oh, God. Oh, wow. And of course, I die. I'm going to have to do that again, actually. I want to hear that music. Because that kind of sounded like the underground music from Super Mario, actually. Oh. Okay, well, I'm going to have to get running for this. So it seems to be, after about 20 seconds, the jugs kind of kick in. No, we can't get the life. Yeah, here we go. 22 seconds. Possibly even 21 seconds to flow. Yeah, here we go. Oh god, this is not looking good. No! Okay, this isn't the Mario music. The hell is this music? I have no idea. It sounds like... Wait, is this a studio? Studio. You know the strangest part is? I was actually listening to that earlier. Like, literally. Like, right before I started streaming, I was like, listen to that. So, yeah. And if you're wondering why I was listening to that, it's actually because... basically, it's because I heard that Phil Collins was coming out of retirement. So I was like, you know what, I'm just going to listen to a bunch of Phil Collins' old songs. Actually, maybe this isn't. I'm not sure. It sounds a bit different, composition-wise. Studio. Please tell me this track lost somewhere so I can tell if that is actually what it is. In fact, I'm going to hang around here for a bit. Because I'm pretty sure the boss music will override it, but, I'm assuming that's meant to be Studio. I mean, that's what it sounds like to me, at least. I mean, if it is based on something else, then, someone please tell me. Cut, bitch, cut, bitch, mother. Who's that lover? She's an ooze. Okay, so for some reason I can't, the whole ABC thing doesn't actually, oh god. It doesn't seem to work when you're on the platforms on the sides, which is kind of weird. Okay, you'll wait here. I'm gonna have to go and listen to Studio again after I'm done streaming this. But, yeah. Because, like, for a second I thought it was, like, some, like, sub Italo disco music. But I guess not. I also like how the, how, when I go here, the opposite side of the screen kind of goes messed up, too. In fact, I'm actually gonna reset this and, like, go to the sound test and see what the difference is. I'm gonna briefly play the next level and see if I can, like, glitch my way through it. Because I know there's kind of a trick to Marble Zone that you can do, at least in debug mode. But yeah. So let's see what this is about. Let's see how the colors change on this level, see if it's different. Oh. To be honest, I'm kind of glad that as a kid I played this on GameCube. Because with GameCube, you can actually. There's cheats to play the, you know, the NTSC versions. God knows why they don't just default to the NTSC versions. It just seems kind of weird to me. Considering that those are definitely superior to the PAL versions to me. Yeah, here we go. Oh, does it not work on me? Because I have no idea. Also notice the, spoken up glitch set right there. Okay, how do I get up this hill? Okay, I'm going to have to do that. Okay, I guess I can't go up there then. Because I can't bounce off that platform, is the thing. Yeah, sorry, I'm just going to reset the game. I want to see... Oh, there we go. Like, I reset and it took like a second to realize that I reset the console. Not sure if that's a streaming program or if it's just the game itself. So I don't think there were any more requests, so I'm just gonna pick one myself. Let's go for Modern Christmas Edition. Well, yeah, it was kind of funny because my local town centre has already set up their Christmas decorations. It's not even Halloween yet, as I do the stream. So, God knows what else is there. See what. What classic hacks there are right here. Sonic Free Blast. Okay. Sonic North Island as opposed to South Island. Sonic Inverted Controls. That sounds fun. Wait, have I got like prototypes of Sonic Spinball? Why are they all like really small? I'm pretty sure the game was bigger than that. Where's Sonic RPG Console Mega Drive? I want to see. Okay, so... Wait, is this in... Is this in French, I'm guessing? I have no idea what this is. Oh, okay, apparently it's for the 32X. So I can't really play this. So I'm gonna have to reset that. Assuming that it even does anything aside from that page, but yeah. And, let's see. Let's actually go backwards. The S Factor, because, you know, Sonic Saturday M was such a great show that they had to put the characters in there. Let's see. Sonic free check. I'm assuming that's what that means, but Sonic 2 Z. I'm sure there's Z as like ZZ Top. Wait, I have both the hack of shame. Okay, what page is the other one on? While you point out where that is, I'm actually gonna load something up right here. Let's load up Sonic CD Music 2. See what this is. I'm guessing this is just gonna be like music from Sonic CD, but let's see. Come on, load. I suppose because it's like 4 megabytes, it takes longer. I don't know. Yeah, here we go. It crashed there for a second, but yeah. To be honest, like, I wouldn't mind streaming some actual games on this, like, you know, games that were like properly released on the Mega Drive. I'm talking like, you know, legitimate stuff. I don't get why Revenge of Shinobi doesn't work though, because, you know, I mean, that was like a real early Mega Drive game. It's not even like there was any region lockout on it, so I have no idea. But thankfully, I can play that anyway, because I do have the Mega Games 2 cart. In fact, I think I might have actually had that back in the day. Okay. Wait, I just realised that Sonic logo that appears on the beginning, that is actually taken from... Like, they actually used that on a pirate multi-cart for the Famicom that came out, like, earlier this year. Oh, wow. Okay, that actually has the Sonic CD music. Yeah, listen to this. I mean it's pretty badly compressed, but still. Oh, okay, apparently pressing the button stops it. To be honest, a lot of people say the Japanese soundtrack is better, but having grown up with the American soundtrack because I played the PC version, yeah, having grown up with that, I've kind of grown to prefer it for the most part. Like, aside from like the game movie music, which is just out of place. Also, like the Windows Media Player style visual effect. I'm not sure what the numbers are for on the top. I mean, obviously, it's like some debugging thing and stuff. I kind of should have played this one after a break, but wasn't really thinking that. Anyway, let's restart. Yes, produced by and licensed with Sega. I don't think Sega licensed the EverDrive. Although it's kind of funny, the cartridge I have, it actually does have a picture of Sonic on it, so that's pretty cool. So let's see what else we got. Back of Sonic. Assuring Sonic 1. Seriously, what page is the Hack of Shame on? Because I don't see it. Maybe it's here, I'm guessing. No, it was like Green Snake or something like that, wasn't it? I think that's what it was called. Sonic Dreams. Oh, please don't tell me it's like that PC game or whatever. The really weird thing. Let's see. Sonic 2 Beta. Except it's like a hack of Sonic 2, so it's not really a beta. Beta. If you want to pronounce it, but yeah. Oh god, someone actually modded Sonic 3D Blast? Oh, okay, I guess it loads up the select screen by default. That's kind of boring. But okay. It's kind of funny, a lot of people have made mods for like Sonic Generations, which I really need to play Sonic Generations, and I might stream that at some point, because, I don't know, I've heard a lot of people say that one is actually really good, so I should do that. Okay, I don't know where this... I really don't know where this hack is. Sonic Tetris Crash. Yeah, that probably doesn't sound really good. Sonic Green Snake 368. Let's see. So I'm actually looking for this right now. That's why I haven't selected anything yet. Sonic 2... Sonic Gaiden. Gaiden. I can't speak Japanese, so yeah, you have to excuse my English, I suppose. Sonic the Hedgehog Mind. Sounds classic. Sonic the Hedgehog Rocket. Sonic the Sequel Unmastered. I love it. Sonic 3 Kirby partners in time. Is that like Mario and Luigi partners in time? Because that would be pretty cool. But you may have spaces instead of that. Okay, I'll keep that in mind. It should have the... I mean, if that's what the default is, it should have the underscores, but let's see. Version 3.68. Sonic... Oh, is this it? Sonic Green Snake? Yeah. I was just checking the version number, just to be sure. So let's see what makes this the Hack of Shame, according to Mr. Schizo, or Cack, or whatever you want to call him. I mean, I don't know what he likes to be called, but I'm guessing both of those works just fine. I mean, I'm not sure, is it pronounced Schizo? Because I've never actually heard it said anywhere. Like, I know it's the Puyo Puyo character, but... Do any of those games even have voice acting? But I mean, any of, like, the earlier ones? Because I know Puyo Pop Fever has voice acting, and I remember it being really terrible. Okay, is this not work? I'm going to try this again, just in case, but, this might not work, and that really sucks. So, see if this helps somehow, the toolbox. Update OS, I have no idea how that works, but, SPI speed test. Device info, if you would want to know that. FAT32. Yeah. Sadly, I have the PAL Mega Drive. I kind of want to get an NTSC one, just so, at least that way I can run Sonic 1 at the correct speed. But yeah, let's try this again, just in case. Oh, okay, now it works. I think. See, that's what it's meant to look like. This game is unofficial. Well, I kind of figured that, considering that it's a hack. Hack by Green Snake Hacking. Okay. Yeah, I might as well play this crap. Oh, here we go. That signpost. Kind of looks like a mole rather than Robotnik, but okay. Sonic ASM. Well, I know that's assembly. You need to tell me that. Let's see what this is. Oh. Yep, this looks pretty amazing. And it crashed. Okay, I have an idea if it crashes again, don't worry. Because I can do Game Genie codes, but I'm hoping that I don't have to, but I'm not sure. I mean, I don't even know what Game Genie codes I'm playing, to be honest, but I do have an idea on how to get this to work. Let's listen to this. Actually, this doesn't sound too bad, but let's listen to the actual title screen. Listen to this. Amazing. Okay, I give this rate out of 10. Oh, okay, I didn't even press anything that time, so I guess I just didn't press the stop button fast enough, but like, literally, like, as soon as I pressed the stop button, it came up with that, so let's see. I'll give this another couple of tries. So I guess as long as I press the stop button fast enough, it might work. Or not. Okay, I have an idea. And if this doesn't work, then I'm going to have to move on, I'm afraid. But let's try it anyway. Okay. Come on, please. Please work. Sonic ASM, yes, we know. You think they could have put more colours on those screens, but... Well, what? Oh, okay, now it works. Or not. I don't think I'm going to be able to play this. Yeah. Oh, welcome to the stream, Mr. Sonic 08. How are you doing? But, I'm having problems playing some hacks. Like, some of them just don't start up is the thing. Or they start up and then crash when they probably wouldn't on an emulator, I would imagine. So what else should I play? Let's play Mario and Sonic 1, actually, because... You know, Samari, it's got to be better than, you know, the original Samari, because that was not a great game by any means. Yeah. Let's do it. See what this is about. Well, I know what it's about, but, you know. It'd be funny if it turns out this was just the NES game, ported to the Mega Drive inexplicably. I'm not sure. Because the thing is, I do have a... because I do have a Super Nintendo and an Everdrive for it. And I'm thinking of playing, like, Super Mario World hacks, because I know I've got a whole bunch of them. So maybe I could do that at some point. Do, like, maybe a couple of streams where I play those. So, of course, speaking of Mario, yeah, Samara on the Mega Drive. But, what was I going to say? Yeah. I wouldn't mind doing more stuff on Super Nintendo, but for now I kind of want to focus more on Mega Drive and stuff, because Mega Drive is my console, or one of my consoles. There we go, got that nice... Okay, no, it should say Samara has passed that one, not Mario. Okay, that's not how Samara works. I mean, sure, he might have an M on his hat on the title screen, but that doesn't mean he's called Mario. It just means that he happens to like the letter M. Oh. I might actually fail this. Wait, Retro Gen playing Mega Drive games on SNES. Okay, that's strange. I'm not totally sure what the point of that would be, though, because can't Retro Gen play Mega Drive games anyway? I'm not sure, but... I have no idea. But okay. I'm not sure how much longer I'm going to go on for. I think I might play a few more hacks. And call it night, I suppose. But let's just reset. Play a few more. I'm going to be uploading this to YouTube hopefully tomorrow, but I'm not sure. Because I think I might cut out the bit at the start of the stream. Yeah, to be honest, I've never played Vapor Trail. Like, I played a little bit of Guy Oris once. I'm sure I could play both of those games on my Everdrive, but yeah. I mean, honestly, I think my favourite shooter out of the ones I've played is probably Truxton. Mostly for the gameplay. I don't know. I just... For some reason, the gameplay just kind of has a lure to it for me. And it's not even because, like, Classic Game Room says it's the best game or anything. Let's see. What is... What's, like, the funniest sounding ones right here? Sonic 2 Double Jump. Well, that's not really all that exciting. Let's see. Oh god, I ain't playing that shit. Sod that. I ain't doing it. No teleport. Sonic 2 doesn't even have teleports anyway, I'm pretty sure. But new version Eggman Attack. Let's see what this is. Hopefully I get to play as Eggman himself, or Robotnik, or whatever. To be honest, like... The Mega Drive and the Dreamcast are, like, my favourite consoles. Along with maybe the PS1. Because the PS1 just has a crazy good selection of games, I think. Oh god. What is this? Okay, I was not expecting this. This does not look good. Okay, I'm just gonna say that... Oh god. Are you serious? Yeah, let's just make it so you have to do this ridiculous jump to begin with. What's the man who got, like, spin dash all the way through this? Let's see. Nope, I can't spin dash. Oh shit, one of them. Yeah, so it's literally just you have to do a perfect jump in order to make it. That's great. Great level design. Yeah, Kaizo Sonic, that is basically it. Yay, I made it. And apparently they didn't bother to change anything else. Aside from the music, which is now just the boss music. Oh wait, no, they have changed it. So it's like Kaizo Sonic to begin with, and then it's just mediocre for that. I guess. So this is like Sonic in black and white. Oh well. Great level design right here. Just put these random spikes just in the middle of the air. Love this one. I will say that this is still better than Sonic that Hedgehog 2 or whatever it was called. Because at least I don't get stuck in the walls. So yeah. What is it about the boss music? Is it... Let's see what the boss, the special stage's like. Yeah, he did steal all the colours. In fact, you know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of that episode of the Powerpuff Girls where there's like a villain that like steals all the colours from Townsville, and the Powerpuff Girls have to form a band to like get the colours back. I have no idea why. But yeah, that... I kind of want to watch Powerpuff Girls again, actually. But I'm, like, do they even show that on Cartoon Network anymore? I don't know. I used to watch it all the time back in the day. So yeah. I got the Chaos Emerald at least. They don't seem to have done much with the bonus stage or special stage or whatever. In fact, you know, I would actually totally consider streaming the Hummer in the future. The Hummer, if you don't know, is actually a hack of Samori, which was basically just, you know, we're gonna take. Okay, what is it with the. There's some weird effect going in the background. It looks glitchy. Okay, it's not showing it now, but it was earlier. Okay, so nice dick move there to make you fall off the bridge. Okay, I'm falling for that. I'm gonna see if I can actually beat the zone, at least. Yeah, I did it. So this is literally just Sonic 1 with bad colours and bad level design. That's great. Amazing. I bet you any money they've like hacked the entire game to be like this. And you know what? If I beat this and like it turns out what is it, Marble Zone is different, I might actually dedicate a stream to this, or part of the stream at least, where I'll just play through this entire hack. Because I'm a doofus, I suppose. Yeah. I passed that too. Because I'm awesome. You gotta have some mad skills to beat this. Maybe. The metal. See, the thing is, they call it Metal Hill, but this, like, it's not even metal, it's just a hill. You know, it's just hills that happen to be white. Speaking of hills, I will call you when it's Hellfest. Yeah, I had to do that. I mean, it is nearly Halloween, and that's like the most Halloween song I can think of. Yeah, to be fair, this is better than Sonic EXE, because, like, Sonic EXE isn't even a game, okay? It's just a shitty, like, you know, ooh, this is an attempt at a horror story, but there's no actual horror, it's just, you know, Sonic supposedly kills the other characters or something, and it's like, yeah. I remember when I first watched that on YouTube, and I was like, this is stupid. Like, it's not even, like, I could maybe, to be honest, like, I could maybe, like, you know, look past that if, like, if there was some gameplay to it, then I could maybe overlook the, you know, how non-scary the game is. That's the problem with, like, most games trying to be scary, is they're just not. You know, it's like, I can at least, like, respect, like, Five Nights at Freddy's for at least trying. But, like, you have crap like Sonic EXE and Slender and all that. It's just like, stop that. You know, it's like, no. That's just my opinion. And I like how the music changed back to Green Hill, by the way. You know. It would have been, you know, that effect might have been kind of cool if they, like, changed the colours back to what they should be, but, yeah. So let's see if they changed Marble Zone. If they have, I might actually. What's the invincibility music? So they do seem to have changed the rest of the game. In fact, actually, I'm not sure if they changed the design here, because this seems to be the same as well as I can tell. Yep, okay, I totally hit that. There was a caterpillar and user of pain in the ass to hit anyway. Or caterkiller, should I say, because that's what we call it. Flexing my Sonic knowledge right there. But, yeah. Yeah, Virtual Boy Sonic. You know what's funny is, I swear to God, there was someone who, I haven't talked to him in ages, but I remember there was a guy from the school I went to who actually owns a Virtual Boy, and I think he has like a ridiculous amount of NES games. I haven't talked to him in ages. I think one of my friends has talked to him since school, but I don't know, I might have to ask about that. To be honest, I would actually be curious to play Virtual Boy, at least on emulator. I wouldn't play the actual machine itself, because I've heard that it causes, like, I don't know, like, eye strain and all this stuff that I just don't want. You know, I know the Vectrex does that as well. Like, the Vectrex might be a really cool console, but I'm probably not going to bother getting an actual machine. Because of that, you know, my eyes are screwed up enough as it is, you know what I'm saying? Oh, well, they have changed this a little bit. Slightly. Yeah, I think I might do a stream on this at some point. But yeah. Because I have an idea in my head where it's like, I'm gonna play through a whole bunch of these hacks just for the sake of it, because why not? You know, I've played the actual games to death. Why not play a bunch of the hacks? What am I supposed to do here? Oh, I see. Yeah. I get it. Okay, I got the time left. Wait, was there really a point of stature to the virtual boy? That sounds really interesting, actually. I mean, I've never played Snatcher, but it looks pretty cool from what I've seen, and I kind of want to play it at some point. But, yeah, I'm actually going to move on to another hack. But yeah, I kind of want to play a Virtual Boy emulator, because I know there is a Wario Land game on it. I don't know if it's just a port of one of the other games, or whatever. But yeah, I kind of want to play that, and I'm trying to think if there were any other really cool games. Like, I know there was Jack Brothers, which I seem to remember was kind of cool. I know Panic Bomber is on there, but at the same time, there are, like, other versions of that I could play, I'm pretty sure. Like, I think there was a Super Nintendo version, wasn't there? And, yeah, I hogged that Hate Hedge. I was considering playing that earlier, but I decided to skip over it. But let's play it right now, because why not? I just like the title as well. Like, I don't quite remember what this hack is, but I do remember it being kind of funny from what I remember seeing it on YouTube. So let's do it. See what I hog that Hate Hedge is about. I kind of want to do the Robotnik voice, but I know I won't be able to. And I won't be able to point to pull it off. Yeah, here we go. She knows. 1991 ages. Copyright. So yeah, Green Hill. Let's do it. See what happens. Top screen, of course. What was I gonna say? I forgot what I was gonna say. Now. So I know I was talking about the Virtual Boy, and then I think I moved on to something else, and then got sidetracked by I Park that Hate Hedge. Oh yeah, the Robotnik voice. Get a load of this! Like, that's as close as I'm ever gonna get, I'm pretty certain, and even that isn't very good, I don't think. Yeah. Marky Jester, the legend. What did I say to that? I wonder if Marky Jester even watches any streams. I mean, he probably watches, like, maybe, like, some kind of giant aliens. Oh god. So this is where the, weirdness comes in. Legendary. Amazing. It's kind of, it is weird what some programs are able to pull off with this. Like, I have no idea how they do it. You know, sorry, I'm just gonna play the game like this with the backwards R placement. This hack reminds me of... These hacks remind me of the strangest thing sometimes, because this reminds me of... Okay, that's the wrong way. Yeah, this reminds me of that episode of Red Dwarf, where they go back to, like, 1993, and time goes backwards, and, like, all the text is reversed. Except here, time goes forwards, I suppose, but still, you know. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave the hack like this. I'm guessing if I hit another ring box, it goes back to like normal. Yeah, where's the point in that? Yeah, I gotta get all that Erox. Yeah. I have to emit some time. And. Yeah. Whatever that means. Let's do this. I'm gonna say this right now. I love this hack. I kind of want to just play for the whole game like this one day, but I'm not sure. Is it really worth it? I mean, Sonic 1 is times classic, so I guess it doesn't really matter. It's kind of funny, like, because I'm not a big fan of the Sonic franchise in general, mainly because of all the games that have come out since, like, they came out, like, I would say since Sonic Heroes, personally. But I don't know. But I love the older games, and even a lot of games that I don't like that much, unironically, I do still like on some level. Yeah, I mean, I still really like Sonic Adventure. And Sonic Adventure 2, I'm pretty sure I'd still like it today. Even if it is very flawed, like, today's standards. Or in fact, even the standards of the time, I suppose, to an extent. But you know, like, Sonic Adventures 1 and 2 were kind of much older to an extent. Along with the older games. Because, you know. See, I don't know. I mean, Sonic. Maybe Sonic Heroes is alright, but, like, Like, I had it on PS2 back in the day, and I wasn't really a fan personally. I didn't get into it back in the day. I might try get a copy again. I don't know if I'm going to get it for the PS2 or GameCube. Because the problem with the PS2 is that PS2s themselves aren't really that reliable nowadays, especially when I'm just playing, like, CD games. I mean, I can play my DVD games just fine, and I'm pretty sure Sonic 2 is one of those. Sonic Heroes, I should say. I want to check, have I still got Sonic Heroes? Because I don't remember. Okay, I do. I do have that. In fact, I actually have Sonic Unleashed on PS2 as well, which I know is supposedly one of the worst versions of the game, but I just have it anyway, because, well, I've been cheap. It's kind of funny, I feel like with a lot of my favourite games, I really need to look into, like, which versions of them are the best, like, whether it be, like, you know, the later-gen Sonic games, or the Bubble games, or whatever. Because it's kind of funny, like, you play Bubble on Famicom, it's really good, or the NES, or whatever. And then you play, like, the sequels, and it's like, no. They're not as good, like, they're still playable, but, you know. I mean, Bubble 2 is really good, but still. So, yeah, I think I'm going to play one more hack, and then I think I might be done with the stream for tonight. I'd like to thank everyone who's been watching and all that. I'm going to try to get this video up, or the stream up on YouTube as fast as I can, and, you know, have that uploaded and all that, just in case anyone particularly wants to watch it again. So let's play... What seems funny? Let us play... Let's play Sonic with Fries. Let's see what this is. Maybe it's like that Sonic hack with the onion rings, where it's like, you know, you collect too many onion rings and you die of cholesterol poisoning or whatever. Is there such a thing as cholesterol poison? Yeah, the thing is, I have a 32X folder, but the thing is, I don't have a 32X yet. I am planning on getting one when I can. Because I do really want to play the 32X games, and I know the Everdrive can play the 32X. But yeah, I'm not able to play them right now, but hopefully I'll be able to... Oh, got the subscriber already. But yeah, hopefully I'll be able to play them soon enough. Okay, is this working? Or... I have no idea. Oh, there we go. But yeah, basically I've kind of got that 32X folder just ready in case of, you know... The hell? Okay, what? Wait, that was like a different Sega. Like, what the hell's going on? This makes no sense. But, okay. Why has it got this Sega? You know, I'm going to try one more. Because I want to end with, like, an actual one. To be honest, I've never played Virtual Racing Deluxe. I mean, I have the Mega Drive version, which is alright. I mean, obviously, it's nowhere near as good as the other ones, but, you know. For a Mega Drive game, it's impressive, at least. Okay, let's say that much. But yeah, I've played that, and I've played the PS2 remake on the Sega Classics Collection. I can't talk today, but, yeah. Let's play... Let's play Sonic Dreams. I'm hoping that's not what I... Oh, no. The vibes that I get from that title. Hopefully it's not that. It shouldn't be, because I'm pretty sure this was made before that. Sonic 3 Complete. What's the difference? Oh, I think I've played that before in a stream, actually. If that's the one where it's got all the weird options and that, then yeah. Wait, Act 3? What the hell? Okay, so again, just like that other hack that I played, this is all in black and white. Don't know what that's about. But yeah, I'm totally gonna have to make a note of some of these games and then, like, play them at some point. Well, they have changed the level design, at least. Maybe. Yeah, they definitely have. But yeah, I'm totally gonna make a note of some of the games that I've played and then play them in full at some point. Or at least try to play them in full. I guess full elsewhere, I can just, you know, double select away from them. If I need to. Also, is it just me or does Sonic have his eyes closed? Oh, there, his pupils are just missing. Your eyes are hurting from this. The thing is, I have a pretty high tolerance when it comes to, like, eye bleeding stuff. But, yeah, let's just say the bootleg stream on Saturday. If I was using the Game Boy player to play the bootlegs that I'm playing on streaming, yeah, my eyes would be bleeding pretty badly. Okay, let's just say that much. But I'm kind of getting ahead of myself. Yeah. But let's just play a level of this and then call it a night, I reckon. Let's see if we make this. Okay. I don't think they've even changed the like, blood design for the most part. It's like they changed the beginning, and that's really good. See, I can still go through this. Thank God this shortcut's here, because I don't like this level much. It's way too long, I think. Kind of overstates its welcome, you know what I'm saying? So you have to change the boss at least. Oh no, you don't. And the music kind of glitched there. Look, well, actually, no, I think it sounds like this anyway after a while, but still. Yeah, I don't get, like, what is it with his closed eyes? It looks kind of weird. Oh, actually, I just had an idea pop into my head. You know what I should do one these days? I should do, like, a, like, bubble themed, like, bootleg stream. Not, well, maybe not necessarily bubble, but, like, that kind of style of games. Because I have a game... At least, hopefully, I'll have a game come through soon that I want to get. That I really want to, you know, play. And, you know, that kind of fits in with that. You know, I have Super Bowl Bobble MD, and I have, like, pro versions of, like, the Bowl games and all that. So maybe I could do that at some point. I'm not sure when, but I might be able to do that. To be honest, I have not played any PC Engine stuff. To be honest, I think once I'm done streaming this, I will actually get a PC Engine emulator and play a whole bunch of games on there, because I've been meaning to play a few games on there, like the Bonk's Adventure games, I think Wonder Boy was on there, if I remember. I'm trying to think what else. Oh god, well, this is going to go well. But anyway, what was I going to say? This definitely lives up to its name, I'm going to say that much. But anyway, yeah, I really do want to play the PC Engine at some point, because, like I said, you know, those games that I mentioned, along with, like, Parasol Stars, I find it really weird they put Parasol Stars on the PC Engine and not any of the other games. But I suppose it's nice to have a really good version of that game, at least. What else was on there? I can't remember off the top of my head. At least none that I can remember that I really want to play. So I'm trying to think of, like, there was any parodious games on the PC Engine, but I don't know. But yeah, there's a whole bunch of games of that that I want to play. So I'm totally going to do that once I'm done playing all this stuff. So I think I'm going to play this level, and then I think I'm going to be done with this stream for tonight. Hopefully, if I'll be able to, I will totally stream on Halloween, which is the Saturday, and do a stream then. If not, then I should be able to stream on the Sunday. Oh, you have a PC Engine Duo Wall. That sounds pretty awesome. To be honest, I would totally get a PC Engine. It's just I don't really have the money for it right now. Because I'm kind of focusing on like getting Famicom stuff and Mega Drive and all that. Because, you know, I have those consoles already and I kind of want to, you know, have the games I really want to get for them. So, yeah. I know the PC Engine has like a CD add-on and all that. I know It Came From the Desert is one of those games, so yeah. I remember seeing, like, the wrong prey for that, actually, which is pretty cool. But yeah. The cookie monster, what the hell? So, am I going, like, backwards through the zones or something? I guess not. Yeah. Let's do this. Yeah, I did it. Or not. I think I'm getting mixed up with Act 3, actually. Let's just have to do the cookie monster. Why is the, like, if this is meant to be black and white, why is part of the background purple? Like, I don't get it. Oh god. Ugh, no, did it. Probably shouldn't do that in the first place, to be fair. Anyway, I think I'm gonna, like, give my goodbyes at this point, seeing as I'm about to close the stream. Yeah. So, I think, yeah, I'll see you later, people.